Hello, welcome back. I'm Pastor Kat. This is your 5-minute devotional. If you've been following along with our study, you know we are in the book of 1 Samuel. We are all the way up to chapter 28. Now, Saul is in the land of Endor. No, not that. Seriously, not that Endor. And he has realized that the Philistines are encamping a little ways away, which brings him a great amount of fear. He knows that he and his men are not going to fare well in a battle. And that brings us to our passage. I'm going to go ahead and read it, and we'll chat about it a little bit. It is out of 1 Samuel chapter 28. I'll put it on the screen here. And it says this, starting at verse 3. Now, Samuel was dead, and all of Israel had lamented him and buried him in Ramah, his own city. And Saul had removed from the land those who were mediums and those who were spiritists. Now, the Philistines gathered together and came and camped at Shunem, and Saul gathered all of Israel together and camped in Gilboa. When Saul saw the camp of the Philistines, he was afraid, and his heart trembled greatly. When Saul inquired of the Lord, and the Lord didn't answer him, either by dream or by Urim, or even by the prophets. Then Saul said to his servants, "Seek for me a woman who is a medium, that I can go to her and inquire of her." And the servant said to him, "Behold, there is a woman who is a medium at Endor." Again, not that Endor. Now, here, Saul has not only realized full well that his back is against the wall, and God is not answering him. You add to that the fact that Saul has already outlawed spiritualists and mediums. If you want to think of those in modern terms, you can think of people who practice witchcraft, those who perhaps are involved in Wicca, those who seek to commune with those who have already died. This is against the law. Saul absolutely knows better, but he's not sure where to turn. So he takes kind of an alternative spiritual direction here and decides to seek out this medium. It's easy for us to say, well, clearly this is not very relevant to me today. And I would propose that that is not at all the case. There are a number of different things people look at today when they feel like God isn't answering them. The first thing I think we need to realize is the Bible is very clear about spiritualists and mediums and seeking out the dead and how his truth lines up with us today. If you're interested in more study about that, I'll put a few of the verses down here so that you can study them on your own. Feel free to let me know what you have found in them. I would love to hear where your study has led you. So that's the first point. The second one is actually a little bit different, and that is once in a while in our lives, we are seeking God and we do not hear the answers, or at least not the answers we want to hear. And that brings us to our parallel passage, James chapter 4. Again, I'll put it here so you can follow along. It says this, "What is the source of quarrel and conflict among you? Is it not the source of your pleasures that wage war in your members? You lust and you don't have, so you commit murder. You're envious and you cannot obtain, so you fight and you quarrel. You don't have because you don't ask. You ask and you don't receive because you ask with the wrong motives, so that you may spend it on your pleasures." Now, James kind of deals with the same topic that Saul is dealing with, and he gives us two things to consider. One is, have you genuinely asked the Lord to answer your prayer? Have you actually spent time in your proverbial prayer closet chatting with God and saying, "Here are my issues, I would like answers"? If you haven't earnestly done that, then what are you waiting for? Go ahead, put pause on this video and go and pray to the Lord your God and ask for guidance. The second advice James gives is that if you have asked and God still has not answered, maybe, just maybe, you've asked with the wrong motives, because it's something you want, something you desire, as opposed to actually following through with the truths you already know. So my encouragement, not only to myself, but to all of you as well, is to seek the Lord in all righteousness. His timing and my timing very seldom line up. But when his will and my will for my life do line up, then he is very quick to answer and take care of his blessed children, of which you can call yourself one if you are a follower of Jesus Christ. If you struggle with these issues of God not answering your prayers, or perhaps seeking other ways to a spiritual life because living by the Bible isn't working or not working quickly enough, please share them down below. I would love to enter into prayer with you and engage with you and your life in that way. We are, of course, the global community under God, and so I would be happy to be a part of your life in that way. Well, God bless, and I'll see you next week. Thank you.